they both rotate beer. Yeah.
This is the sun and
the earth and moon.
Moon travels around the earth once every day.
The first phase of the Primary Connections 5E's teaching and learning model is engage. In this phase, students become actively engaged both physically and mentally with an activity or question.
Our question was, how can you harness energy?
Engage captures the student's interest and stimulates curiosity.
Off you go!
It also provides opportunities for students to express and examine what they know about the concept or skill being introduced.
Educational research tells us that, particularly in science education, that the ideas and the explanations students bring with them to the classroom, to the topics that we do, are the most important starting point.
We must engage with what kids think they know prior to moving into the other phases of the 5Es.
Students come to the science lesson with ideas that they have picked up or constructed from their past experiences. Many of these ideas will be non-scientific. By eliciting students' thoughts and explanations, the teacher is able to plan activities that will challenge or confirm these ideas.
In 1 year, the Earth goes around the sun a lot of times, 365 times.
Yeah. Well, I think that the Earth and the Moon stay like that and the Sun orbits around the Earth.
The teacher hears a student make scientifically inaccurate claims. First of all, that's great knowledge for the teacher. That's part of the diagnostic assessment process. But the real key is probing with questioning and getting kids to reason and think and articulate why they think that.
Why do you think that, Maddie?
Because you can see the sun moving, and when it comes above the horizon and goes over, it moves around, and that's how you get day and night.
In the engage phase, it's really important that the teacher doesn't correct or evaluate answers. Then the students get an understanding that it's okay to say what they're thinking about, that they're not going to be judged or evaluated. It's about inquiry, it's about exploration, it's about investigation, and that's what we're after.
What can you hear?
A tinkling sound.
It's vibrating very, very fast.
It sends a message to our brain.
It's so much richer when you question openly, because the children then are prepared to give you the answers.
I think there's a lot of children, particularly in a Prep 1 class, who are really afraid to be wrong. And they won't say anything in case they're wrong, but if you take everybody's idea and they realise that it's risk-free, it really encourages them, and that's where the enthusiasm starts from.
It feels like squishy time of toy.
I know that we've got some absolutely amazing science thinkers in this classroom. Sometimes scientists make a claim. Here's my claim. All baby animals will look a lot like their parents when they grow up. So you can choose whether you agree, disagree, or whether you're not quite sure.
There are many strategies used in the engage phase of the Primary Connections units to elicit students' ideas and conceptions and to help activate students' own thinking. These include strategies such as think box, concept maps, agree-disagree, and label drawings.
That's the bit that makes this thing work.
By vocalising, drawing, or acting out their ideas, students are actually beginning the learning process as they start to make sense of their explanations. As the students reveal their thoughts and beliefs, they are recorded under the What We Think We Know column of the TWLH chart.
I like the chart because everyone can put their ideas up. If they're all up there, you can look at other people's ideas and build on it.
My idea is that the moon orbits the Earth, and Chris's idea is that the moon orbits around the sun.
It doesn't matter if it's right or wrong, it's just what you think, you know.
Using the word think helps students to realise what they think can change, and this is the purpose of learning.
That's a good thought.
The TWLH chart is really like documenting the whole sequence of reasoning. It parallels the thinking process and documents the whole process from go to woe.
Any questions that the students might have are recorded in the What We Want to Learn section of the TWLH chart.
How you make Sango?
Wonderful idea.
They're owning the inquiry process by developing their own key questions for us to investigate.
By adding the students' thoughts and questions to the TWLH chart, the teacher sets the stage for the next phase, explore. The purpose of the engage phase is to create interest and stimulate curiosity, provide an opportunity for diagnostic assessment, allow students to compare their ideas, and start to raise questions for inquiry.